number 89. Oh, ye God, we pray thy name, Lord, in love we bow before thee. On our earth as ever remain, all in heaven above adore thee.
Our Father. 106.
At the risen, precious Savior, that thy love may glory, thou hast saved and cleansed and filled me, that thy life that shadow be, shadows only, blessed Master, but with all thy wondrous power,
spring is at hand.
Number 748.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would your evil of victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is
Jesus.
Good evening and greetings in Christ's name. I can say I was blessed to be here this evening already. The songs we sang were truly a blessing. And I know there's not as many out here. I don't mind that at all. But for when David Lee texted me and asked me if I'd had devotions, said it was a singing, my mind right away went to singing. And I know we just had a singing. Marvin had a beautiful devotions on singing in heaven. And so I wasn't sure exactly where to go with it, but I decided to look at a couple examples of praising God in the Bible, where people are praising God even in the hard times. It comes easy to praise God, and when you're on the mountaintops and life is going good, it seems like it comes very easily. But when you're in the valley and you're going through a difficult time, it seems like it can be easy to just sit there and self-pity and not actually praise God. So for scripture reading this evening, I decided to read out of Psalms 59. Deliver me from mine enemies, O my God. Defend me from them that rise up against me. Deliver me from the workers of iniquity, and save me from bloody men. For lo, they lie in wait for my soul, and the mighty are gathered against me. Not for my transgressions, nor for my sin, O Lord. They run and prepare themselves without my fault. Awake to help me, and behold. Thou therefore, O Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, awake to visit all the heathen. Be not merciful to any wicked transgressor, Selah. They return at evening. They make a noise like a dog and go round about the city. Behold, they belch out their mouths. Swords are in their lips. For who say they hath? Doth hear? But thou, O Lord, shalt laugh at them. Thou shalt have all the heathen in there. Because of his strength will I wait upon thee. For God is my defense. The God of my mercy shall prevent me, and shall let me see my desire upon my enemies. Slay them not, lest my people forget. Scatter them by thy power and bring them down, O Lord, our shield. For the sin of thy mouth and the words of their lips, let them even be taken in their pride, and for cursing and lying which they speak. Consume them in wrath, consume them that they may not be, and let them know that God ruleth in Jacob unto the end of the earth, Selah. And at evening let them return, and let them make a noise like a dog, and go around about the city, and let them wander up and down for meat, and grudge not, them be satisfied. Verse 16 and 17 were really the main verses I wanted here. We'll read them and then I'll make a few comments. But I will sing of thy power, yea, I will sing aloud of thy mercies in the morning, for thou hast been my defense and refuge in the day of my trouble. Unto thee, O my strength, will I sing, for God is my defense and the God of my mercy. If anybody had an excuse to sit there in self-pity, it would have been David. Here he was anointed as king, and in this count it says in the Bible that Saul sent to have him killed. But then, towards the first part of the chapter, he's saying all these things, but then at the end of the chapter he's praising God. He didn't sit there in self-pity. He went on and praising God for his strength. That's where David got his strength from. The other one was that I thought of was in Acts 16 with Paul and Silas there. And we all know the account very well, so I'm just going to jump in here at verse 25 and 26. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praise unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loose. Here's another account of it. where people, you know, seemed like they had all the reason to sit there in self-pity and just, you know, not do what they were doing, praying and singing. But here, God blessed them tremendously. And actually, you know, in the end there, if you keep reading it, actually saved the jailer's household in that. I have a couple other verses here. Psalms 34:1, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. The word all stood out to me then, that one. I'll bless the Lord in at all times. That don't leave any room. That means it's just really. Another one was Psalm 69:30. I will praise the name of God with this song and will magnify him with thanksgiving. And then in closing, I'd like to read two more verses in Psalms 95. Psalms 95:1-2. Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise. And make a joyful noise unto him with psalms. That's my prayer and challenge to each one is to, you know, even though there's times that, you know, it seems like when it's easy to sit there and pout, or not literally, but in our minds maybe we do, and think, why God, why have you put me here? And but just remember that it's always a blessing to you and to others. Is and this devotions was for me. I hope y'all got something out of it, but it was a devotions that I needed in my own life. And so yeah, sit prayer. Or close. I will. Okay, let's stand for prayer. Dear Lord, as we come before you this evening, we want to thank you for your many blessings. Thank you for granting us the beautiful day you granted to us. And thank you for allowing us to come to your house this morning and hear a word from you. And again this evening to lift up praises to you. Lord, just ask you, you would help us to praise you and every season of our life, and Lord, that even in the hard times that we can find, reach out to you and find the strength in you to praise your name. Just be with us this evening. Guide, lead, and direct us in your name, we pray. Amen.
Let us pray for each other, not for your heart and make you free. His love.
7:43.
Walking in sunlight, all the winds turn.
Amen.